History gives wine heart and soul. For the history of wine is the history of mankind. It soothed the soul of Odysseus on the most epic journey in our history. The first act of Noah after the great flood was to plant grapevines, the very roots of our civilization. You can study the story of the Hermetic Knight of Hermitage or Dionysus, the god of wine, but it would seem as though it is the lifeblood of our human story. But once you drink this heavenly elixir, it is gone forever. Wherever there was once an epic war, there you may find great wines, the strife of Europe, the violence of Prohibition, and the earthquakes of California, unleashing angry giants into the cellars of great wineries. But that plethora of destruction only strengthens the resolve of those that make the wines. For it wasn't just the violence, it was a risky dedication. Like the great Robert Mondavi said, in this fine wine business, it's not going to take 5, not 10 years. It's going to take a lifetime. You have to be willing to take a gamble. You have to put your whole heart and soul into what you're doing. But that's all. It's very simple. Simple, like the grape and the vine, yet complex like the wine itself. For the depth of our consciousness may go only as deep as the richness of our wine. The depth of the soil can be a taste of the past. A magnificent transformation, all through a glass. Wine is an extension of our human condition. We create these living beings and toast to their glorious demise. For it brings food and life together in a millennia-old tradition of sharing, laughing, loving, and preserving the harvest to last for generations. Wine doesn't just go deep in our story. Whether in La Rioja, Chile, China, or Sonoma, it's interwoven into the fabric of our civilization, deeper than the oldest empires, deeper than we can possibly fathom. It's vines intertwined in the roots of humanity, a delightful extension of our human intent, a kind of liquid music for the soul. Some say the blood of mankind's savior itself runs in the vines of the grapes which yield their fruit as men must do with diligent work. Wines, like men, are susceptible to scrutiny, called weak or strong, held in contempt or high honor. But entire men's lives are dedicated to the creation or consumption of this drink, a drink with ageless wisdom and folly. Wine is its own kingdom. It's ephemeral, graceful, can spark violence, but more often peace. Wines are as eternal as songs and legends, but all three work together for immortality. And that is the flavor of the human condition, found only in a cup of its wine. So perhaps the winery is as close to Eden as we can get.